Morning, Maple Bear. Good morning, everyone. It is so great to have you all here today. Welcome to our Math Expo 2021.
It's a pleasure to share with all of you what our little bears are learning in math. And to start this magical moment, let's find out together what toddler prepared to us. Let's go.
What shape is this?
Circle.
A circle. Good job. It's a star. Can you say star, Rafa?
We get my
star. Let's make a star. Yay! A yellow star. Yay! A triangle. What else? Let's put some more.
Hello, this is Ms. Louise, and I'm here to talk about toddler's presentation. So in toddler, the little bears start to learn about mathematical and logical aspects. They learn about numbers, shapes, concepts as up and down, big and small, inside and outside, and so many other things. So this video will have the Indian's presentation, shapes, counting time, colors. I hope you enjoy. Bye bye.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
4. Ten, very good. 6. Nine. Very cool. What color is this?
Blue.
Blue. Enrico, what color is this?
Yellow.
Yellow. What color is this?
Yellow.
Orange. Very good. And this one? Purple, very good. And this? Enrico. And this?
Green.
Green. Good job. Seven. Ten. Very good. Two. Go. One, two, three, four, five, six. Pointer off. Six, seven, eight, nine, and go, Levi, and 10. Very good. Count for me. 6. Oh, 6. Here. 6. 7. 8. Very good, Guilherme. Gabi, where is the blue piece? The blue. Very good. And the orange. Where's the orange? Wow. 10. Very good. Go. Very good. The blue. Where's the blue? Yes, give it to me. Where is the orange? Orange. This is red. Where's the orange? Orange. Where's the orange? Orange. Okay? Where's the purple? Purple. Purple. Very good. Thank you.
Miss Dai, there are so many little balls here. Do you know how many balls we have in this pot?
I have no idea. This is very difficult. Should we count?
Count? But we'll be here forever. There are just so many balls.
Oh, we can ask our little bears to help us at home. Little bears, send us your guesses on the chat.
Great idea, Miss Dai. So, little bears, we're counting on you. Send your estimations in the chat.
And we'll be very glad, because the little bear that sent the correct answer will get a special gift from Maple Bear.
But be aware, only your first guess in the chat will be considered.
And don't forget to write your name on your guesses.
And talking about estimation, there is one group of warrior bears that worked very hard on estimation this year.
Really? Let's check out Year 3's amazing presentation.
A number using the place value. It means to give a value to each number. For example, 37, 7 ones and 3 tens. 852, 2 ones, 5 tens and 8 hundreds. It is important to remember that we always start placing the number on this chart from right to left or by the ones to the hundreds.
Do you want something even easier? It is to show a number using the base 10 name. For example, number 36, 3 tens and 6 ones, or number 272, 207 tens and 2 ones. I thought it was easy.
No, easier than that. You can write the numbers in words. Let me give you an example. 15. You just write it how you say. F-I-F-T-E-E-N. This is super easy.
To help us understand numbers in a better way, we can use base 10 blocks. Each piece represents something. This small cube represents the ones, and we call it unit cubes. This stick is called the rods, and it represents the tens. This square represents the hundreds, and we call it flat. It's important to remember that 10 ones make a 10, and 10 tens make a 100.
Do you know that you can represent numbers in pictures? Like 752 is just do 7 flats. Five rods and 300 cubes. See? Very simple.
We can count objects one by one.
We can make groups. For example, 5 by 5 are easy groups of 10.
Guys, how many groups of 10 we have?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
How many leftovers?
5.
How many in total?
85.
Is counting by 10 easier?
Yes.
Do you guys know Mr.
Alligator?
He can help us compare numbers.
Yes, look. We have the numbers 25 and 37. Which of them is bigger?
Number 37. So we place Mr. Alligator mouth open facing number 37 and we say 25 more than 37.
If you have the numbers 18 and 7, Mr. Alligator's mouth will be facing number 18 and we say 18 is greater than 7.
Oh, can you help me organize these numbers from greatest to least?
Of course, let's start organizing numbers from greatest to the least.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Let's send Leticia the message to organize these numbers from greatest to least to the greatest.
This is how I sum numbers.
The addition charts help us find the sum of different numbers.
I don't get this.
Do you need help, Dani?
Yes, please. How can you sum this?
It is easy. Let's use the addition chart. We find the two numbers and see where the lines meet. There's your result.
Whoa, just this?
Yes, very simple, right?
Super easy. Thank you, Pietro.
You're welcome, Dani.
One addition strategy is using doubles. To get a double of a number, we add the same number to itself. For example, the double of 2 is 2 plus 2 equals 4.
You can use the addition chart to find double. What's the doubles of 8? Follow the lines. It is 16.
Knowing all the basic facts for 10, we can figure out our addition facts. We can decompose a number. For example, 6 plus 8. I can turn the 6 into a 4 and a 2. I know that 8 plus 2 is equal to 10. And 10 plus 4 is equal to 14. So, 6 plus 8 is 14. See?
Certain numbers and facts are related or make up a fact family, and there are only 3 numbers in each family. They are related because you can add 2 of the numbers together to get the third number.
Marina, can you get my hand?
Of course.
I have these 3 numbers, 7, 5, and 12. How long is the real life that?
It is simple. 7 plus 5 equals 12. And 5 plus 7 equals 12 too.
And the 2 real life facts?
You subtract, for example, 12 minus 5 equals 7.
And I do 12 minus 5 equals 7.
Yes!
Awesome! Thank you!
A very simple way to use subtract is counting back. See this example. 13 minus 9. Start at 9. If you add 1, will be 10. So we know that we need 3 more to get to 13. So the difference of 13 and 9 is 4.
You can use buttons to help you subtract. I like to use buttons, for example. I have 15 buttons. I take 6 buttons and out. And I have 90 buttons left.
To find a missing number, think about the related facts. For example, 8 plus equals to 15. Instead of addition, you can make subtraction. For example, 15 minus 8 equals to 7. So 8 plus 7 equals to 15.
Miss Gabi, what are you laughing at?
These math jokes.
Math jokes? So tell me at least one, because I want to laugh too.
Okay, so guess what? How do you keep warm in a cold room?
How do you keep warm in a cold room? I have no idea, Miss Gabi. Little bears, can you help me on your guesses? Write your answer on the chat and send it to us.
And while we wait for your answers in the chat, let's see SK's project.
Hello everyone! Subtitles is the ability to instantly recognize the number of objects in a small room without the need to count them one by one. And the SK students practice subtitles every day in school through different activities. Check it out!
What is your number?
10, I know.
Very?
Plus 5 equals 10.
Excellent! Go, Gabi!
6 and 6.
Very good. What number makes 6 plus 6? Excellent, Gabi! Cool. Good job! Go, Lorenzo! What is the number, Lorenzo?
10.
Way to go! Number 10. 10. What is the number, Lucas?
3.
Great. Number 3. What is number 3? Awesome. Organize. What is the number, Mila?
8.
Excellent. Number
3 plus 3.
How many is 3 plus 3, Annie? 6. Way to go, Annie. Marcela, what is your number?
3.
What is your number?
3.
Excellent. Number 3. What is the number, Maria Fernanda?
7.
What is the number?
7.
Very good. What is the number 7? Excellent. What is your number? What number did you get?
6.
You also got the number 6, Vivi!
Yeah,
same number! Easy. What number did you get? What number?
4.
Excellent! Number 4. What is the number, Olivia?
5.
Way to go, Olivia! Number 5. What is the number, Malu?
6.
Way to go! Number 6. Wow! Good job, Francisca! Excellent! Your turn, Luca. Roll the dice. What is the number, Luca?
7.
Which one?
7.
Number 7. What number did you get, Isa?
9.
Excellent. Number 9. Good job. Your turn, Maria Sofia. What number did you get, Maria Sofia?
10.
You got the number 6. Great.
Thank you.
colhendo bem.
Two.
Muito bem. E aqui é uma colhinha de 7. Cadê a colhinha?
Vai.
Muito bem.
Eleven, did you find? Yes, and you, Alice, throw the dice. How many? Now, SK students will subtitle with Mr. Breno. Let's go. 10.
Congratulations, SK! I learned a lot about subtitling.
Yes, they were great. But you know, Miss Gabi, I'm still curious about your riddle problem. I have read some answers in the chat.
Okay, good job helping Miss Dai, everyone. And the answer is, you stay in a corner. They are always 90 degrees. Fahrenheit, of course.
It's really funny, Miss Gabi. You got us on this trick, huh? But now it's time for a real and serious math problem. Let's watch out. Year one, working very, very hard. Let's go.
How can we show 10?
5 plus 5. 6 plus 4 equals 10. 7 plus 3 equals 10. 2 plus 8 equals 10.
How can we show 7?
2 plus 5. 3 plus 4.
How can we show 7 in a different way?
4 plus 3. 4 plus 3.
How can we show 8?
5 plus 3. 5 plus 4.
Can you show 8 in a different way?
2 plus 6. 5 plus 5. 3 plus 7 equals 6. 7 plus 2 equals 10. 6 plus 5, 11. 4 plus 7, 11.
5 plus 6 equals 11. 10 plus 1 equals 11. 9 plus 2 equals 11.
10 plus 1 is 11. 9 plus 2 is 11 too. And 1 plus 7 is 11.
6 plus 5 equals 11. 2 plus 9 equals 11. 3 plus 8 equals 11. 4 plus 7 equals 11.
9 plus 2 equals 11. 6 plus 5 equals 11. 3 plus 8 equals 11. 4 plus 7 equals 11.
The number is 1, 3, 5, and 7, and the adjacent is 7 plus 3 equals 10, and 3 plus 5 equals 8. 4 happy faces, and 2 moons, 4 plus 2 equals 6.
2 more 2 equals 4. 4 plus 1 equals 5. 5 plus 3 equals 8.
The boy is 5, 6, 4, and 3.
Uh-huh.
3 plus 4 equals 7. 6 plus 5 equals 11. 1, 2, 3 emotions. Plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 equals 8.
On the wings, what are the additions you have on the wings?
10 plus 1 equals 11. 6 plus 8, 14. 10 plus 8, 18.
How can you show number 10?
6 plus 4.
How can you show 10 in another way?
7 plus 3.
How can you show number 7?
4 plus 3.
Can you show 7 in a different way?
5 plus 2.
How can you show number 8?
4 plus 5.
Can you show 8 in another way?
3 plus 5.
How can you show number 9?
5 plus 4.
Can you show 9 in another way?
6 plus 3.
4 plus 5 equals 9. 7 plus 2 equals 9. 6 plus 3 equals 9. 8 plus 1 equals 9. 9 plus 0 equals 9. 3 plus 6 equals 9.
3 plus 4 equals 7. 2 plus 5 equals 7. 1 plus 6 equals 7.
3 plus 6 equals 9. 5 plus 4 equals 9. 2 plus 7 equals 9. 4 plus 5 equals 9.
5 plus 4 equals 8. 6 plus 2 equals 8. 0 plus 8 equals 8. 7 plus 1 equals 8. 5 plus 3 equals 8.
2, 6, 8, 9. 2 plus 8, 6 equals 8.
8 plus 2 equals 10. 1 heart plus 3 clouds equals 4.
6, 7, 10, 8. 7 plus 10 equals 17. 8 plus 6 equals 14. 2 moons and 2 suns equals 4.
4 plus 4 equals 8. 3 plus 3 equals 6. 5 hearts and 3 clouds equals 8.
Look, Miss Dai. Look, little bears. Did you know that these are actually numbers?
Is that so? They look like just little drawings for me.
They do, but they are actually numbers. Before our counting system was created by the Arabs and the whole world started to use them, many other peoples created different number systems. Let me show you some. These are Egyptian numerals.
Oh, I see. And we have a lot of other number systems. We use Roman numbers up to today. Look at this. And we can even use the numbers just to have fun. Listen, little bears, we have one student that worked on the numeral system in the lead topic, and he prepared a very, very good surprise for us. Let's check it out together.
Hello, my name is Matheus and I am your two students. My lead topic is counting system. Last year, I built a domino game. In the right of the card, we have a Indo-Arabic number. In the other side, we have other counting system, a number of the other counting system. The counting system that I chose was Mayan, Roman, Egyptian, and Babylonian. The game is simple. It's like that. We have two in Babylonian here. So we have to connect with the two in Arabic.
Oh, Mateus, this is an amazing game. Thank you so much for sharing it with us.
Yes, I loved it too, Mateus. We are very proud of you. And you know what, Miss Dai?
What?
We have some more little bears that can show us how to represent numbers in different ways. Let's check JK's presentation.
What number is this? What number is this?
4.
10.
Where is this? Very good. Can you go to the next? What number is this? What number is this?
3.
Which one is it?
3.
3.
Alright.
What number is this?
Three.
number is this? What number is this? This? Red. Orange. Green. Next number. Which one is it? Seven. Go there. Green. Orange. Red. And red. Congratulate. Which one is it? What number is this? Three.
What number is this? What number is this?
Five.
One, two, three, four.
Hi everyone, I'm Miss Chris, and JK will show you a little bit of how they learn math. With games, they recognize numbers and their quantities, and also create patterns to develop logical thinking. Have fun!
What number is this?
Six.
What number is this? What number is this?
Five.
One, but how many?
Three,
this is four. One, two, three, four. Aê, four.
Davi, vamos contar aqui, ó, essas bolinhas? Conta com a mamãe.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight.
Qual que é o eight? Mostra pra mamãe. Qual é o eight? Very good! Fala pra mamãe a sequência das cores.
Blue, purple, yellow, black,
What number is this?
6.
10. And which number is 10? Ah, that's number 10.
What number is this? 3. What number is this?
5.
What number is this?
6.
What number is this?
8.
In the other one?
9.
What number is this?
6.
What number is this?
10.
What number is this?
12. Yeah.
What number is this? 2. What number is this? What number is this?
6.
What number is this? 9.
Wow, we're so proud of JK. They did very well on their presentation about patterns and numbers. Did you know that patterns is something that we can use in other contexts too, such as music?
Really? And you know what? I've discovered something very, very interesting, Miss Gabi.
What is it?
We can make patterns using our body.
No, you're joking.
No, I'm not joking. Do you want to see?
Yes, of
okay,
course.
Okay, let's go. Pay attention.
Wow, amazing. Do you think little bears at home can join us?
Ah, for sure. They are doing great on our math expo. Do you want to join us, little bear? Can you be ready? Can you stand up from your sofa, shake your body, and come with us? Let's go, Miss Gabi.
Wow.
Very nice. Did you like it?
Yes, a lot.
But I have something to tell you.
What?
This process in music, when we use our body to make sound, is called ostinato.
Wow. Uh-huh. And you know what, Miss Dai? I know someone that knows a lot about music too.
Really?
And he can come here and help us with some other patterns.
Who is it?
Mr. Everton!
Mr. Everton!
Hello,
Mrs.
Hello, little bears! Yes, what Miss said, we have ostinato in music. Ostinato is repetition, pattern, all right? Like this, for example. Everyone at home, follow me, all right? Ta ta tum 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 pa. Ta ta tum 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 tum. Let's try. Ta ta tum 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 pa. All right, we can use this with music also. You do the repetition, the ostinato, but for rhythm and putting a song. Little crab is not a fish. Little crab lives in the sand. Little crab has just one wish to be the best surfer in the land. See, we use the pattern and a song together. So very common in music.
Very nice, Mr. Everton. Thank you so much for your participation. And thank you so much for teaching us. We're so glad to learn new things.
I say thank you. Really happy to be here with you.
And you know what? Now we have another amazing presentation. Let's check out nursery work.
Hello everyone, how are you doing? So this year for the Nursery Math Expo, we decided to start working with the numbers and their quantities. And our main goal with that is to start building a bridge for our students between an abstract concept for them that it's the numbers, together with its concrete correspondence by showing them many ways that they could do that. So further, this will be a skill that they will be using their daily lives when they need to set up a kitchen table or, for example, for them to create better ideas of space and many other forms that you're going to be seeing soon. I hope you guys enjoy it. Take care. See you next time.
What number is this? 1, 2, 3, 4. We need 2 sticks. Do you need another one? Not really, right? 1, 2. Pick up the 2. Can you draw for me 3 circles? Can you draw 3 circles?
Seven.
more for one?
Yeah.
Cross, two circles. Right here.
Manu, how many dots can you see? Number two. Yes, this is number two. And how many dots can you see?
One.
Can you find number one? Good. Lucas, how many dots can you see? Where is number one? Yes, where is? Good job. And now, how many dots can you see? Where is number three? Good job, buddy. And now?
2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay, where is number five? Good job. And now, how many dots can you see? Where is number one, babe? Super! How many dots can you see now?
1, 2, 3.
Where is number three? Good job! Pedro. How many dots, Pedro?
1, 2, 3, 4.
Where is number four, Pedro? Can you put in the right place, please? Good job! How many dots can you see now, Pedro? The next one. Right here, Pedro. How many dots can you see?
One.
Where is number one? Can you put in the right place, please? Thank you. And now? And how many dots can you see, Henry?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Where is number eight, Henry? Okay. And now, let's count.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Where is number six, Zenhi? Awesome. You can put it on. Good job, buddy. Where is number five, Maria? Can you put it in the right place, please? Thank you very much. And next one. Number 10, Maria. Can you put in the right place, please? Yay! Good job. And next one, how many dots can you see? Where is number 2, Maria? Oh my goodness. Yeah! Can you see and find the number? Where is number five, Luke? Is this number five? Oh, thank you very much.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Where is number 10?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Good job. Where is number eight? Awesome, Luke.
Hey little bears, are you ready for a real math problem? Miss Dai and I have to sort these baskets of toys for JK to use next week. In this basket, we have 41 toys. In this basket, we have 37 toys. In the three baskets altogether, we have 95 toys. How many toys do we have in this third basket?
Wow, Miss Gabi, that's a real challenge. Guys, how many toys do we have in the third basket? Send your guesses on our chat. And while we wait for it, we are gonna see a different way of using patterns. Mm-hmm. Yeah? Let's check out the amazing job year four prepared for us.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Math Expo. This is year four's project. The stairs going up or down?
Need to know. If it's my dogs that are barking at the window. So I count one by one the windows to see if it's my dogs.
It is all part of the attendance to establish order in our everyday lives.
Patterns help us learn sequencing and to make predictions.
One of the most common things we do when we get lost is to pile them up.
How could we count blocks in a pyramid?
What do you think it's easier, counting one by one or using other strategy?
We worked on this problem in your math class and we are going to share it with you.
The problem is Jane uses a cube to build a pyramid with 7 layers.
The top 4 layers have these numbers of cubes, 1, 4, 9, 16.
Suppose the pattern continues.
How many cubes are in the 7th layer?
Did you get the numbers?
With 7 layers. The first layer has 1 block, the second 4, the third 9, the fourth 16, the fifth we have 25, the sixth we have 36, and the seventh we have 49 blocks. We have 7 lines of 7 blocks. And then we just go like 6 lines of 6 blocks, 5 lines of 5 blocks, 4 lines of 4 blocks, 3 lines of 3 blocks, 2 lines of 2 blocks, and just 1 block.
Patterns can be by 2, 4, 3, and 5, and a lot of many numbers that can have a high number like 300 or 3000.
You can find the pattern rule multiplying or adding the numbers.
The pattern rule is multiply the number by itself. Like 1 times 1 equals 1, 2 times 2, 4, 3 times 3, 9, 4 times 4, 16, 5 times 5, 25, 6 times 6, 36, 7 times 7, 49.
Or you can do 1, 2 plus 2, 3 plus 3 plus 3, 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4, 5 plus 5 plus 5. 5 plus 5, 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6, and 7 plus 7 plus 7 plus 7 plus 7 plus 7 and plus 7.
How many cubes are in the pyramid?
1 plus 4 plus 9 plus 16 plus 25 plus 36 plus 49.
There are 140 cubes in the pyramid.
so much, Irfar. That was really interesting.
And very helpful too. Using patterns like this makes it easier for us to do multiplication.
Now, Miss Gabi, let's see who can help us to separate the toys in the three baskets.
Yes, many answers in the chat. Thank you everyone who collaborated. And congratulations to Giordana and Micaela Neto. The answer is 17. This is a two parts problem. To solve this, first we need to make the addition of these two baskets. So we make 41 plus 37. This is equal 78. Then we make the total of the baskets, which is 95 minus 78. And this is equal 17.
Very good, Miss Gabriela. Thank you so much for your explanation. It was amazing. So let's watch out what the little bears from year two has to prepare. They did a very nice work on patterns, and this is very important for us to learn from them. Let's go together. Let's go, year two.
Addition is a basic of addition of putting two numbers together.
Like 2 plus 1, 4 plus 9, 11 plus 6, 25 plus 40.
2 plus 1 is 3, 9 plus 4 is 13, 11 plus 6 is 17, and 25 plus 40 is 65.
A subtraction is one of the basic operations.
10 minus 2 is 8. 7 minus 5 is 2. And 19 minus 3 is 16.
Examples of subtraction are 10 minus 2, 7 minus 5, and 19 minus 3.
Remember that in a subtraction, the biggest number always comes first.
I have 20 blocks. I don't have blocks.
Is
want to play this ball. One, two, even.
What the calculator say to the students?
You can always count on me.
Too. It was lovely to listen to all your explanations.
Exactly. We're learning a lot of very important things here today. And you know what?
What?
We're not over yet.
Really?
You still have one more chance to make your guess in our estimation competition.
But before we tell you the results, let's watch Year 5's presentation.
Numbers every day. Mental math in action. What are the benefits of mental math?
Mental math is when you calculate something in your head without using tools such as calculators, pen or pencil, and paper. Mental math helps us in a lot of things, such as shopping, cooking, building something, converting one unit into another, investing, figuring out a score or a grade, and comparing values of things.
Mental math actually keeps our brain quick and sharp. The brain, like muscles, gets stronger and more efficient with use.
Ready for some mental math?
Yes!
What is the number? The number has 5 digits. The 1,000 digit is the same as 18 divided by 9. The 100 digit is the same as 60 divided by 10. The 1 digit is the same as 2 times 4. The 10,000 digit is the same as the number of days in a week. Finally, the 10th digit is the same as 1,000 minus
991.
Again! Your answers are right.
This is a matching game that you get the patterns and the rules and you need to match them. For example, you get a pattern and you see that is decreasing or adding. Like this. Here have 72, 60, 48, 36, 24, and 12. So it's decreasing. And I look here to see what is the rule that matches with the pattern, like minus 12, that match with the pattern. So I get and put here, and you need to find all the patterns with the rules.
Rounding numbers, 6,493. First, you round to the nearest 10. When you are rounding to the nearest 10, you need to look at the 1. If it's higher than 5, you round up. If it's lower than 5, you round down. Now she's going to round to the nearest 100. It's the same rule, but now you look at the 10th digit. She's going to round to the nearest 1,000. Is that also the same rule, but now you look at the 100th digit.
then put an output machine in game. She will pick a number
and put it in the in column. Then I will get a row.
Then I will follow the rule and put the number in the output column. Then she will put another number. Now we will continue and she will try to guess what is the rule.
This is the place value game. I have the start card. Who has 605 tens and 3 ones?
Me! I have 653. Who has 408 tens and 8 ones?
Me! I have 488. Who has 509 tens and 1 ones?
Me! I have 591. Who has 306 tens and 8 ones?
Me! I have 368. Who has 207 tens and 1 one?
Me! I have 271. Who has 109 tens and 8 ones?
Me! Who has 309 tens and 6 ones?
Me! I have 396. And we are done.
It was a complex way of using patterns. You did a very, very hard work. We are very proud of you.
Yes, and we are also very amazed for your collaboration in the chat. It was especially busy today.
And Miss Gabriela, now is the most expected moment in our morning, besides our Bears project, of course. Who gets to the closest number in our balls? It's gonna get a thank you gift from Maple Bear.
Yes. Thank you for everyone who collaborated in the chat. But the special gift is going to a little bear, okay? It was Nayara Sebi. Congratulations! The correct number of balls was 253. And she said 223.
Congratulations! Clap your hands for her. Well, Miss Gabi, I have to tell you something.
What?
Can you believe it's almost time to finish our event?
Oh, no.
Yes,
Miss
Gabriela.
Time flew. Oh, Miss Dai, let me just show what Nayara Seb is going to get.
Very nice.
But yes, what a shame. Our event is getting to this end.
But Miss Gabi, don't be sad, because we are going to have our next event very, very soon.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Do you know what it is?
What?
Our June festival is coming soon.
Oh, that's good news. So we would like to say thank you very much for everybody who enjoyed us today.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. See you next time.
Bye-bye, little bears.
Obrigada. Tudo que foi ensaiadinho. Aí. Obrigada a todos que estiveram conosco, que acompanharam, que participaram da produção desse evento. A todos os professores, a todas as famílias e principalmente a todos os alunos que todos os dias trabalham um pouquinho com a matemática e permitiram que a gente fizesse esse evento num formato diferente, mas muito divertido, muito gostoso. Lógico que a gente preferia tê-los aqui, mas a gente se diverte muito montando e apresentando isso aqui para vocês, tá bom? Então, foi um grande prazer estar aqui mais uma vez. E como a Miss Daiane falou, em junho a gente está aqui de novo com o Arraiá Maple Bear.
Hello, everybody. It was just fantastic, this mass event, you know? And we are always very happy to have all of you here with us. And I think that the greatest message we could learn with this little bears is that they are thinkers, not a calculator. So that is the point of studying at Maple Bear. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.